WBAL News Now and the big story of the day on WBAL News Radio 1090. FM 101.5 and the WBAL mobile app.
So a big victory for Joe Biden in South Carolina. The firewall worked, you have to say. And not only worked, but perhaps it actually put out the socialism fire that is burning bright within the Democratic Party. We'll see, because Super Tuesday is coming up tomorrow. There's not a lot of time to just, you know, revel in the big win for Joe Biden and perhaps use it to gain momentum. Can you get momentum in only 2 days' time? Because that's what he has to do in order to beat Bernie Sanders, with 14 states tomorrow going to vote and some major states where Bernie Sanders looks like he's going to do pretty well, including California, which is what we know. Texas is in there. Virginia is in there. North Carolina, some major, major states. But it certainly was the best news possible if you are someone in the Democratic Party who does not want Bernie Sanders to be the nominee, because he took it on the chin. Joe Biden won, and Pete Buttigieg has decided he's donezo.
The truth is that the path has narrowed to a close for our candidacy, if not for our cause.
And so he's out. Clearly, he's not a big fan of Bernie Sanders. He attacked Bernie Sanders in the last debate, saying that Bernie Sanders was going to be terrible for the party as a whole. And Joe Biden was out making that case as well on Meet the Press.
I do. I think Bernie Sanders' position on a number of the issues, even the Democratic Party, are going to be very controversial. The idea that you're going to find $60 billion and not going to raise $1 trillion, I should say, not going to have to raise taxes on middle class people. The idea that, we're talking about immigration. I mean, if Bernie had voted for if we had passed the immigration bill that I voted for and Teddy Kennedy and others voted for about 10 years ago, we'd already have 6 million people who were undocumented American citizens. I mean, so there's a lot of talk. We're getting down now. Everybody's going to look at Bernie's record as closely as they've looked at mine over the last 5 months. And I think they're going to see some stark differences in where we stand.
So there's Joe Biden making the case of why Bernie Sanders is bad for the Democrats. He was asked also about, you know, what's it look like for you on Super Tuesday. Said, look, some states are good, some states are going to be bad. And he still believes that he can actually win the primary or win the nomination before it gets to the convention. That seems to be hard, really hard. The math just isn't there on that front for Joe Biden. And as great as a night as it was for Joe Biden, you could hear in his voice there on Meet the Press that he was a little tired. And that is going to be a role in it. You've got two guys who are really old, Bernie Sanders, who's got heart issues as well, going against each other. In fact, Joe Biden, again, did what Joe Biden does. And this is unfortunate if you're a Biden supporter, because he forgot what show he was on, because he was with Chuck Todd on Meet the Press, that soundbite we played. And then he was on with Chris Wallace on Fox News Sunday.
Mr. Vice President, thank you. Thanks for your time. Please come back in less than 13 years, sir.
All right, Chuck. Thank you very much.
All right. It's Chris,
I mean,
but anyway.
Chris. I just did Chris. No, I just did Chuck. I tell you what, man, these are back-to-back. Anyway.
No, it's okay.
I don't know how you do it early in the morning, too.
Safe travels on the campaign trail. Thank you, sir.
All right. Hello, Detroit! You know, it's Spinal Tap for Joe Biden. David Axelrod was asked about, hey, does this mean Michael Bloomberg will get out of the race? He believes that Bloomberg should drop out after Super Tuesday and take all of his money that he's spending on ads for himself and basically give it to Joe Biden if he really doesn't want Bernie Sanders to be the nominee. So we will see with Super Tuesday tomorrow and 14 states. We're going to have a clearer picture of exactly where they go and if there is any kind of momentum for Joe Biden, or if this is just the zombies' last stand. Because let's not forget, before South Carolina, everybody was saying that Joe Biden's campaign was done. Could it be Michael Bloomberg that could actually win this thing? How are you going to stop Bernie Sanders? The only way you could do it is go to a contested convention. It was a zombie candidacy from Joe Biden. It was done. It was dead. It wasn't going anywhere. So is this just a one-off in South Carolina? Is it a dead cat bounce, as some people would say in politics, or is it really the start of something where Democratic voters are saying, hey, let's rally behind Joe Biden? Now, Bernie Sanders was on yesterday as well, and he was asked a couple of different times about how this is going to have any kind of impact on him and what he would do if he is not the nominee and Joe Biden winds up winning, or if he is the clear favorite and what he believes that Joe Biden would do if that is the case.
Trump is such a threat to our Constitution, to our way of life, that while Democrats may have differences of opinion, yeah, I have differences with Joe Biden. No great secret. Joe voted for the war in Iraq. Joe voted for a bad bankruptcy bill. Joe voted for bad trade agreements. But at the end of the day, I have known Joe Biden for a very long time. He's a decent guy. I have no doubt that if I win, Joe will be there. If Joe ends up winning, I will be there. We are going to come together, and President Obama, in my view, I hear said this, will play a leading role in helping whoever the Democratic nominee is.
Does he believe that? Do you think he really believes that if it is clear that he has the plurality of votes but doesn't have enough to clinch, that Joe Biden will say, yes, Bernie is our guy, and that Barack Obama will go out and stump for Bernie Sanders? Somehow, I don't even think Bernie Sanders believes that is a guarantee, that is a slam dunk.